All right, what's up, you guys? So today's video is gonna be about how to simplify your weight loss. I'm gonna make this video to make it very, very simple for anybody that's watching this video. After these little few things that I'm gonna show you, you will be able to actually incorporate this and actually help you lose that weight. Every time somebody asks me to help them with their weight loss, this is exactly what I tell them. So let's get to it. All right, when it comes to weight loss, everybody thinks it has to be so complicated. It really is not complicated at all. There's only a few things that you're gonna need to make this happen. First thing, we're gonna need a scale. Boom, a digital scale is the best. Boom, one that tells you, this one doesn't wanna turn on because it has to be on the floor, but one that tells you digital. It tells you like 150.4, 150.6, not the ones that has a little needle that it doesn't tell you to the point something. So you need the scale. Next, you're gonna need an app where you could input all your calories. My best option that I would tell you to use is MyFitnessPal. Why? Because I'm already familiar with this, and I think it's the best app because it has a lot of food options to input when whatever you're eating. There's other apps that you could track your calories, but sometimes it doesn't have the foods that you are looking for, so sometimes you have to make them yourself. So MyFitnessPal is very good at having all those foods already. So MyFitnessPal, you could find it on Android or Apple. You shouldn't have a problem. Number three is just gonna be a piece of paper that has two columns, okay? Column number one, you're gonna put the date. In column number two, you're just gonna put your daily weight right next to the date. So if it's June 28th, you put your morning weight there. And then the next day, your morning weight. And then, so yes, this losing weight method that I'm gonna show you guys is gonna need you to actually weigh yourself every single day. The reason is because every time that we weigh ourselves, after 7 days of weighing ourselves, we're gonna calculate our weekly average, okay? Because every day your weight is gonna fluctuate, sometimes by 2 pounds. One day you might be 2 pounds heavier, 2 pounds lower, depending on the day. But after you have all those 7 days, we're gonna add those first 7 days, add those numbers, and then divide it by 7, and it's gonna spit out your average weight of the week. And you're just gonna put it right next to it. So I made like a little arrow, like I connected the 7 days, and then you're just gonna put the number right here. Then you're gonna weigh yourself the second week, the following 7 days, and you're gonna do the same thing for those 7 days. You're gonna add those next 7 days, and then divide it by 7, and it's gonna spit out your weekly average weight, and you're gonna put it there. So now we're gonna actually compare the weights of every week. Now we're not gonna compare day to day, we're gonna compare week to week. Okay, so this method that we're gonna use of weight loss is just gonna focus on calories. So I know maybe you have heard me talk about protein, carbs, and fats, tracking your carbs, your protein. We're not really gonna focus on that right now. We're just gonna focus on calories overall. Me, when I track calories, protein, carbs, and fats. But when you're kind of starting, it's better to just start just with calories. You don't wanna start right away with protein, carbs, and fats because it's gonna be so complicated that it's gonna be so hard that you're more likely to give up. You're gonna be like, you know what, this is too much. I can't do this. Trust me, let's just focus on calories. So for whatever workouts and cardio that you're already doing, this method is not gonna change any of that. So if you're working out 4 times a week and you know doing cardio 3 times a week, continue that. Continue what you're doing, your regular weight training and your cardio. Right now, what we're gonna try to find out is how many calories you're consuming every single day. So the whole plan here is when you have that app and you have to track every single calorie you're taking in. So if you're gonna eat a granola bar, you're gonna have to input that granola bar on the little app. So it's just say 250 calories. If you're gonna go out to eat at Wabba Grill, look up how many calories that Wabba Grill bowl has and enter it there. It's gonna be necessary to know every single thing you're eating to put it on that app. If you aren't unable to do that, then this method is not gonna work for you. But you don't have to be so anal about it. If there's a food that you think that you can't find the calories, just kind of estimate them. You know, go online, go on Google, and just kind of search how many calories in 4 ounces of chicken or anything it is. Just look for it and try to get as close as possible. So once you have your whole calorie intake for the day, then that's great. Now you're gonna do that for the second day, for the third day, for the fourth, for the fifth, for the sixth, for the seventh. So for 7 days straight, I want you to have every single calorie in every single day. So we're gonna see, okay, first day you had 2,000 calories, let's just say. Next day you had 2,500 calories. You know, third day you had 3,000. Another day you had, you know, kind of close to 2,000. Another one, 2,500. So we're gonna find out all those 7 days. And what we're gonna do is kind of, we have to find a starting point. So if you say that you're eating at every day average about 2,500 calories, then we're gonna be like, okay, you know, because all days are gonna be different, but just say that average through, you look at all the numbers and you're like, I'm about between 2,500, let's just say. Then we'll be like, all right, let's set that up. Every single day from now on for the next 7 days, I'm gonna hit 2,500 calories. So what it's gonna look like is your first week, you're not really gonna change anything. You eat normally, how you normally eat, you know? I don't want you to try to, because you're gonna track everything, now you're gonna eat super clean, you know, just chicken and veggies, and then your calories for the week is gonna be so low. I want you for the first week, just eat like you normally eat, but enter everything on that app. So you could really see, I'm eating 3,000 calories in this day, that's a lot. So once you kind of know what you average for that first week, you're like, all right. Then that second week, every single day, try to hit just like an average. Don't go to the extreme one, don't go to the lower one, just kind of hit the average one. So if you are between 2,000 calories to 3,000, just eat 2,500 for the next 7 days. Every single day, you're gonna be tracking your weight. So for the first 7 days, you're gonna track your weight, and then after you have those 7 days of weigh-ins, you're gonna add those seven, divide it by seven, and then you're gonna put that number on the side. So you can know that those seven numbers, after you divide it by seven, that's that number. So once for the second week that you're eating the same amount of calories every day, because by then you already know what your average calorie intake for that week is gonna be, you continue to eat that, you hit that same amount of calories every single day for the second week, and you're gonna keep weighing yourself for that second week. After you have those 7 days of that second week, you're gonna add them and you're gonna divide it by seven, and it's gonna spit out another number. So now you're gonna have those two numbers. You're gonna have that first number from that first week, and then you're gonna have that second number for the second week. Now you're gonna look at those two numbers, the first week's number and the second week's number. Just say that you lose weight. You kept the same exercise weightlifting routine, you kept the same cardio routine, and you lost weight. Then cool. Then you're just gonna, the third week, you're gonna continue eating the same thing. And in hopes to actually lose weight again on the third week. Just say that that third week happens, and you add those seven numbers and you spit out that third number, and then you compare the weeks and you didn't lose weight anymore, then now there's something that we have to do. So now that that third week, we didn't lose any more weight. Now we have two options. Now we either have to increase the cardio, because if you increase cardio, you're gonna burn more calories, meaning that if you increase cardio for that next week, you're gonna lose weight. Or if you decrease your food intake, say, like, we're gonna keep that same example, you were at 2,500 calories, then we're gonna have to drop like 200 calories. So now we're gonna consume 2,300 for the following week and continue every single day 2,300 calories for the next 7 days, then you will lose weight. So that's gonna depend on you, whether you wanna increase cardio or decrease food. So you could increase cardio by 200 to 300 calories. So you're just gonna, for that next week, you're either gonna do 200 to 300 calories of cardio more than you normally was doing, or you're gonna decrease 200 to 300 calories of your food intake for that week that you had. Or you could do a combination, 200 more of cardio and 200 less of food. It's up to you on the combination that you wanna do. But now that we kind of know where our calorie intake is, because by that time you're gonna know 2,500 calories is not making me lose weight, so now you're gonna drop 200 calories. And then you're gonna continue eating 200 calories less than what you started with for the following week in hopes of losing weight. If by any chance you do not lose any weight the following week after reducing some 200 calories, then you're gonna do that again. You're gonna drop another 200 calories for the following week and continue that every single day in hopes of losing weight the following week. Or you could increase cardio for the following week to continue to try to lose weight for the following week. So that's pretty much what we're doing here. Right now, I'm gonna give you guys myself as an example. I'm eating 2,400 calories a day. Right now, I'm working out 4 times a week and I'm doing cardio 4 times a week. And I'm losing a little bit of weight. I'm losing about 0.5 pound a week. I'm not changing anything every week until I do this whole calculation and it shows that I'm not losing any more weight every week. If this week and this week is the same weight, now there's something I need to do. Decrease 200 calories. If I'm consuming 2,400, I'm gonna have to drop to 2,200 calories, or I could keep my calories the way it is, but now instead of doing 4 times a week of cardio, maybe I could add an extra session of cardio and my food stays the same. So you have to play around with those two things, the cardio and the food. One either has to go up, the cardio goes up, or the food goes down. And the only way you're gonna know what to change is if you're tracking your weight. If you're not losing any more weight, then something has to change. If you are losing weight, then don't change anything. All right, guys, so this pretty much wraps up the video. I hope you like it. I didn't wanna get too into detail because I don't wanna make these videos too long, because I know a lot of people, I mean, your time is precious, so I don't wanna make these long videos where you have to watch for so long. I'm gonna make them as short as possible and compact as much good information as possible. So hope you find these useful. If you like the video, please press that like button at the bottom. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. I really appreciate it. And I'll catch you guys in the next video.
Bye.